Enterprise for Scientific Research and Technology, Academy of Scientific and Technology, and Forbes Cairo Innovative Exception. My name is Hisham Rahman Hassan, the Investigation Student, Mr. Rockman, Professor of Science, Cairo University. The title is Innovative Design Pattern Flow Microarray Chip, a Theoretical Proposal. Background is this proposal is not the unique or not the first of this type, but a lot of research, few, not many, not be accurate and not give the aim from this type. Before we talk about our my innovation, I will give a background of two techniques, lateral flow immunoassay and a microarray. Lateral flow immunoassay, as you know, the Binance test, self-test, all we know is the famous script. In 1964, serum proteins, the first time we did serum protein from the lateral flow immunoassay, and in 1976 for HCG in urine as the Binance test. The principle of this test is based on antibody-antigen interaction between human and the animal and the vaccine. It's not for human only, but for all biomarkers. The design of antigen-antibody interaction give us particular and unique quantitative results. We can detect protein, DNA, and toxins and other biomarkers from it. By 2020, the market for it reached $8 billion worldwide. The basic structure of the lateral flow immunoassay strip is composed of four components. Sample bed, release bed, membrane, and this membrane is a place of reaction having, which have two line, test line and control line. Finally, absorber bed, which keep the flow of the liquid sample for one direction. Operation of lateral flow, as we see here, the analyte, sample contains a light here exposed as across. Suppose it has four epitopes. We suggest the epitopes. Okay, a light baby from human or animal or plant. Sample bed, first sample bed designed from nitro from cellulose sheet or fiberglass to separate the solid components of biological material from the liquid components. And permit the microcomputers to flow to the conjugate bed. Conjugate bed here containing a metallic signal emitter like gold nanoparticle or silver nanoparticle or carbon nanoparticles. A conjugate was antibody specific for one epitope for the analyte. After incubation and reaction happened with the one epitope of the analyte, the migration of all components from the conjugation bed is flow to the first line, which is test line. Test line here contain antibody specific for another EB2 for the analyte. So the reaction will happen if the sample containing the target analyte we want, the reaction will happen at this is named sandwich assay. So you know we notice that the antigen or analyte we want is captured in the test line. Finally, the control line here has a secondary antibody against primary antibody in the conjugated membrane, chamber. So even if I found or not found, the control line will give the reaction. So the control line here is indicated for strep is a very good strep, not poisonous or not spoiled. This scanning with microscopy was two magnification bar. We can see here 4 nanometer gold nanoparticle is visible in 20,000 magnification. This is I want to show a huge distribution of EU nanoparticle here because I need it in my innovation. In monoarray strip, as you know, we are using in medical labs. As another step for virus detection, H. pylori, or even subcutaneous markers like BSA, CA, whatever. As you know, in strip number 8, invalid test, because it does not give any line at the test or control line. B is a negative test, this gives only on the control line. C is a positive, which gives two lines. This strip of this technique give us a qualitative detection, not quantitative. Application of lateral flow immunoassay is a huge. Forensic science, medical diagnostic, industrial, food safety, military biodefense, consumer diagnostic, animal health, blood banking, agriculture, aquaculture, environmental. So for this huge application, the market of this technique is a huge too. But we're facing some problems here. The problems related to the technique itself, antibody gene access, serological techniques, with specificity in this technique, around 70%, not exceed 90% or near from 100%. This is a problem in this technique. Second, all this strips is a mono-rabbit test, so I can just marker unlike by unlike. So if when I need to make a large screening for multi-marker, 1,000, 2,000, whatever, I can't make it very economical, very cost of it. Second technique was is a macro array. Macro array technique, as we all know, it is around